2015 was the worst year on record for wildfires in the western United States. One of the first fires of the season, the Wragg Fire, burned more than 8,000 acres. Just a few months before the fire, my sister and I took the day off and went hiking in Stebbins Cold Canyon, enjoying some rare one-on-one time. I remember hiking up the ridgeline and being struck by the different hues of green. From mountains to trees to bushes, the land was so dense. Today I'm going back for the first time. I'm meeting with Jeffrey Clary, who manages the reserve, to find out what's changed.
Hi, Kat.
Hi, Jeffrey, how are you doing?
Yeah, great, welcome. Stebbins Cold Canyon Reserve, which starts just a little bit behind us, is part of the UC Davis Natural Reserve System. And for us, this is an outdoor classroom and laboratory. What makes it special for this particular reserve is it's shared with the public as well. So the people get to be out here and see this beautiful site, and at the same time learn a little bit about what scientists at UC Davis are up to.
So there's the public and scientists are anxious to get this place up.
Absolutely. We've had scientists out here literally from the day after the fire was put out. So the really great thing about this place is we were able to get the learning happening immediately in the aftermath of the fire. We have researchers that are really interested in what's going to happen to these slopes once the rains really get started, and what's going to end up in the streams and what that's going to do to water quality.
Can we take a walk?
Absolutely.
Okay,
let's go.
Great.
My first reaction at looking around is it's still really pretty. There's still trees, many of which are green, but there's also a lot of black.
Down here you can actually see how hot this fire was. A lot of these rocks have totally split from the heat. The moisture inside the rock just pops when... Oh, and look over here. There's a classic fire-following species. This is what we expect to see. Here's a little lupin coming in. Using this place as a way to find out how do you model soil movement after a fire when it rains. That's something that's hard to do because you're never there right at the time that you need to be there. And here we are able to mobilize the researchers to do that. The same thing for the vegetation and the wildlife recovery. It's one thing for it to happen. It's another thing for it to be documented so that everyone gets to learn from it. We're here, we're so close to campus, and they can get out right away and learn something from this.
When I heard that Stebbins had been burned, all I could think about was that day and how all that greenness was gone. The more I talked to Jeffrey, the more my thoughts began to shift. I'd been looking at fire from a human perspective. To nature, fire isn't tragic, it's natural, and we need to learn from it. With climate change and hotter and drier summers, wildfires are only expected to get worse. One researcher excited to document the changing landscape is UC Davis grad student Jordan Carey.
So what are you doing out here?
I'm looking at debris flows, which are very similar to landslides. And we're looking at these debris flows that occur. We want to assess the environment before big rains and after the big rains. So we're currently using this drone to fly over the landscape and try and understand how it changes pre-El Nino and post-El Nino. I hope people will be able to understand what the power of Mother Nature kind of and what debris flows can do to an environment and how drastically and quickly they can change. And just having people, for people to be able to understand that is an important thing so they understand the risks of where they live and whatnot.
You sometimes feel like a little kid that's just out flying.
Yeah,
like,
I do. It's fun.
Helicopters
in
the middle of the
yeah, it's a little, maybe a little more stressful than that, but for the most part, yeah, it is fun to pick them up and fly it around and whatnot.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah.
So you put these all into a computer and kind of take a time lapse kind of?
Not in time lapse, but we stack up all the pictures with each other and then stitch them together, and it makes kind of a broad, you can see a much bigger region all together.
Everywhere you look here, there are signs of new growth. Wildflowers are spreading, and new bits of green are poking out from under almost every burned tree I see. Life goes on, but we still wonder, what will the future forest look like? How should we as humans prepare for it? and respond to it. It's easy to look at this fire as tragic. But for the researchers studying its effects, the fire has given them a chance to answer those questions, which is a good thing.